Hey guys, Joe Pye here at Advanced Innovations. Thank you to all my subscribers that stuck with me during the AR series. That was something that I had to get out of my system, something I've been wanting to do for myself for a very long time. And if nothing else, if you're not a gun guy or gun girl, I hope that you at the least saw some of the setup, some of the location techniques that I use, some of the holding techniques that I use, which could translate to manual machinery quite easily. And if nothing else, that you took that away from that series, if you watched it. Well, today, I decided to show you a modification that I made, am making, recently made to my three jaw chuck that I made to all the chucks that I used to use years ago. And not until recently did I need to do it. So I figured this is a great time to show you exactly what I did. Even on very simple jobs like this piece right here, this is a 4-inch diameter 60-61 chunk. It's about 3/4 inch or so thick. When you try to face this off, you'll face it off rather easily, but when you flip it around and face it off, about the only way to readily get parallel surfaces is put it in soft jaws or have some kind of a stop set up on your chuck. Well, I've seen some really sophisticated stops made for 3-jaw and 6-jaw chucks, and the one that I've used successfully about a billion times has served me well over the years, and I figured I would share that with you. It's a perfect opportunity. So let me show you what I did to my chuck to make it a lot easier to align the second side of your part for a parallel puck when you're done. So let's take a walk over the mill. I'll show you the setup, then we'll put the chuck on the lathe and we'll cut a piece, and it's that simple. Let's take a walk. Okay, the modification that I made to this specific chuck was I drilled a series of holes in the face. These are 1/4-20 holes. They're about 3/4 inch deep. And if you're wondering how deep to drill the pilot hole, drill about 1/16 inch away from the top of the scroll. You do not want your drill to go through that channel where that scroll is, because then you just start getting chips in your scroll through the holes. So these are bottomed holes and they do not go through to the scroll. You can do one, you can do two. All I did was took this distance right here, split it in half, and then split the gaps in half, and it worked out to about 3/4 inch on center. Setup is pretty straightforward. Chuck is up on 1, 2, 3 blocks. Got some tall threaded rod, all thread, whatever you want to call it, and adjustable heels on them. Laid it out by eye. Critical alignment here is not required. So lay it out with a pen, lay it out with a Sharpie marker, whatever. But drill your holes, do not go through the front. All right, let's get this guy back over on the engine lathe and I will show you what attaches to those holes. Okay guys, the chuck is mounted on the machine. And now let's just assume that the part that you need to cut needs to be fairly parallel, and I mean more parallel than you're gonna get by eye. So I'm gonna show you how I handle that. On the first side of any part, and I'm gonna drastically mess this up just to show you, you can put a part in a 3-jaw chuck and squeeze it, and it's got it. But you can clearly see that that is a little bit out of skew. If you're gonna put a part in for a first side operation, don't bank it up against something and trust that the saw cut is perpendicular to the OD. Let the OD and the contact with the jaws tell you how it's sitting. So wiggle it around, gyro your wrist, and bounce this around in the jaws as you slowly come closed with the jaws. The oscillation of the part will tighten up and it'll start to straighten itself out. The more of that OD you can get down in the chuck jaws, the better off you are. All right, I'm happy with that for a first side. And if you're wondering how I know my jaws aren't gonna fly out, if you've watched some of my other videos, I keep a safety index mark on the face of my chuck that I reference against my jaw 3, so I know exactly how far I can open up. Let's face this off and make it parallel. isn't much of a raised burr on this, so I'm not even going to use a file or a 45 degree tool or anything to deburr it, because we still have some remnant from the sanding that was done when the sawing off took place. I'm going to go worst case scenario here, and I'm going to bet you that this next setup that I present you with is faster than installing soft jaws and boring soft jaws for this operation. So this is worst case scenario, and I'm not going to speed this film up either, so take a look. Actually take the part out. I'm even going to take the jaws out and I'll still be the soft jaw setup. Okay, here's where the holes come into play. 1-inch diameter ball bushings. I'm going to screw it right to the face of the chuck. Now, if you've watched some of my other videos about jaw movement that you probably weren't aware of, you got to see the advantage to having a solid standoff right on the face of your chuck. No matter how tight you squeeze on that part, these aren't going anywhere because these are connected right to the face of the chuck. If you want to number them, if you want to number your slots, and you want to number your standoffs, go ahead. That would work just fine. I am not a big fan of turning on a lathe chuck with nothing in the jaws, so I choose to take them out. Dress the face of the standoffs to a common plane. And it'll be real easy to tell if you got all of them. Because you'll go from a saw cut finish to a lathe finish. I think we're good. Don't even have to deburr it because all the burrs on these parts are going in the right direction. They are not going to be in your way. I'm going to bring it back around, put my jaws back in. Let's measure it and see what we got. As a matter of fact, I'm going to measure right at the standoff for sake of demonstration. This is 9.17 1/2. Nine 17 and a half. 9/17 and about 7/10. So I just turned a 4-inch diameter chunk parallel within 2/10 in a matter of minutes. This standoff technique works exceptionally well. It's adjustable for a very, you know, a variety of diameters. It works with the jaws inside, outside, regardless. And if you're not sure about where the stud came off of, by all means, dress it off like I just did. It takes 2 minutes. This is a great trick. If I was you, drill the face of your chuck, make a couple of these, go get them. For sake of convenience, if you end up with a lot of these standoffs, make sure that it's not the depth of the counterbore for the head that is common across all these sizes, but how much material you leave behind. You can see these standoffs are different sizes. The projection of the thread is exactly the same, and the screws are the same. So you don't have to go searching all over your shop for 99 different types of screws depending on how tall your standoffs are. Just make the counterbore thickness of the bottom common across all your sizes. It'll save you a lot of headaches, and you'll only need 3 screws. Okay guys, well that particular technique is more important to get a part parallel than it is for concentricity. But there's absolutely no reason that that particular concept can't be used with soft jaws. You just need to bore the soft jaw lower than the height of the particular standoff, and then you have the best of both worlds. So I hope that helped. It has helped me tremendously in the past. It is fantastic for getting a part parallel, and it took little or no time whatsoever. So I hope you like that. I hope you use it. Give me a comment. Let me know what you think. Thank you for hanging in for the AR series. We'll be back on these lathe videos exclusively for the next couple weeks. And if you have a request, by all means, leave that too. Thank you very much for watching. Joe Pye, Advanced Innovations, Austin, Texas. I'm out.